Welcome to this video tutorial on creating a spreadsheet to manage accounts receivable. Let's get started. I put the sample file in the description. You create a table for the data area as above. Then you name your list of customers. I do this to create a drop-down list on another sheet. After naming the list of customers, I go to the sheet named Amounts and Payment. Here I create a drop-down list of customers. Thus, the list of customers is synchronized between two different sheets. I use the customer list defined in the previous step to create a drop-down list in this sheet. In this example, I'm managing accounts receivable from selling some technology products. Customers will buy products, then they pay partially or pay late. Over time, customers come to buy many times and pay many times. This spreadsheet helps you track customer receivables. It helps you know which customers have not paid you in full. Here I named the list of products to then create a drop-down list. When I add a new product, the drop-down list is automatically added. Thus, the data between the two sheets is synchronized with each other. You follow the steps above to create a drop-down list of products. Next, I enter some data and from there calculate the accounts receivable. For example, in this case Sarah bought two computers. The price of each product is determined in the sheet named Product. You can change product prices manually if you want. I create data tables as above. I create such a table that it is more convenient to use the function. Specifically in this case, I use the VLOOKUP function to find and check the price of the product. So every time you select any product in the drop-down list, the selling price of that product will automatically be mapped. If the selling price changes frequently, I recommend entering it manually. I customized the function to avoid errors when the product cell is blank. If the product cell is empty, the price cell will be empty and no error message will be reported. On the same day, Olivia bought four laptops. Next, I calculate the total amount of each customer for each product type. You just need to multiply the quantity by the unit price to get the total amount. But the customer did not pay the full amount, they only paid part of it. So I need to know how much they still owe me. In this case, my two customers only made partial payments. I follow these steps to track accounts receivable. I named the columns in this sheet as above. I named the column with the list of customers. Next, I go to the sheet called Accounts Receivable Management. I will calculate the total amount for each customer, then subtract the payments. That way I will know how much money they still owe me. I use a function called SUMIFS to calculate the total amount. In this function I use the column names defined in the previous step. I calculate the total amount for each customer. Above is a list of total amounts for each customer. Next, I will calculate the total payments by each customer. You name the column that lists payments. I will then copy the function I just used to calculate the total amount. I change the column in the function to total the payments. So I have calculated the total payments of each customer. A customer can buy multiple times and pay multiple times. So to track that manually is very difficult. This spreadsheet automatically calculates the total amount and calculates the total amount paid. To calculate customer receivables, you just need to use simple subtraction. Above is a simple way to manage accounts receivable. Next, I guide you through managing your receivables over time. To do that, you define the start time and end time. I created two new cells that allow entering start time and end time. I then named the data entry time column. The spreadsheet tells you over a specified period how much the customer has paid and how much money is still owed to you. I named the start time cell and the end time cell. These names are used in the function to calculate accounts receivable for the specified period. I customize the function to calculate the total accounts receivable for each customer over a specified period of time. When you change the time period, the total amount will change. Next, I customize the function to calculate the total payments for each customer. To check the results, I add data as above. On another day, Sarah made another payment to reduce the amount she owed me. You'll see that Sarah's accounts receivable amount will change as I change the time period. Above is a simple spreadsheet to help you manage accounts receivable. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Good luck.